Welcome to broadcast 55. I love Jesus.
Oh, I love Jesus. How many of you know this old school song here? Oh, how I love Jesus. Yes, folks, he's worthy. Hallelujah. Yes, it's a name that I love to hear.
The Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord,
I give my heart and I love you. I love you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Hi, I'm Professor Jerry Fleck, and I thank God for being back on the air one more time. Come on, somebody, let all the people say none tonight. Come on, somebody, let the church say none. So let all God people say none tonight. Let all God people say amen tonight. Today's message, God said, I want to change you. But God said, I want to change you. But God said, I want to change you, my child. He said, I want to change you tonight.
Today, who is the head of my life? I just thank God for being saved. Each time I come on this program, I just thank him for being saved and sanctified, baptized, and filled with the precious Holy Ghost. Nothing can express those words individually like that. They all has a meaning in my life, and I'm glad to proclaim it to the world. And I thank God for the title of this program he gave me, I Love Jesus. How many of you out there love Jesus? Just the feeling to know that name Jesus should stir your spirit up today. Da, 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 da. I just thank God. And in the Bible, some of the scriptures about Jesus, it say in John 3:16, we all familiar with it, would say, for God so loved the world that he gave his only, and I mean his only begotten son that was in heaven with him. When the beginning, when he first created the heavens and the earth, before he created heaven and earth, he always was the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. He gave his only begotten son that whosoever believe in him shall not perish. And everyone know what perish means. That means to be destroyed or not seen again or eternally banished from the presence of God. But on the other side, have eternal life or everlasting life. Life with no end in heaven. And another verse of Jesus' love that I love Jesus about is 1 John 4:16. As we have known and believed the love that God has to us. God is love. Can I emphasize that? God is love. And he that dwelled in love dwelled in God. Let's look carefully at this verse. It said, he that dwelled, that means someone that's in love, not love with your mate, but just dwelled in love as itself, dwelled in God. And folks, what's one of the first songs that we heard as a child? The first song I can remember is Jesus Loves Me. You all know how it goes. Jesus loves me. Yes, I know. For the Bible tells me so. Everyone knows that song. It was one, probably the most popular child song ever written. In John 14:6, it said, Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No other man come unto the Father but by me. And folks, like I was talking earlier in some of my earlier sermons about all these different religions, all I'm saying that this is the way to God, their God, because it's not the same God I serve. So they got the Muslim, the Buddhist, all different types, Catholics, all different types of religion that speaks about the way to their God. They're saying there's many ways, many avenues to Jesus. I mean, many avenues to the God the Father. But my Bible teach, like I just read, John 14 said, Jesus said to him, he is the way. He is the only truth. And he is the only way to life. No man come unto God, but by me. How plain can it be, folks? To me, the verse read as Jesus is the only way. Jesus is the only truth. Jesus is the only life to God. And many religions said, and many religions try to join together to say, we all going to just be one of a accord and unite. And we all going to reach God. But the Bible emphasizes you can only reach God through one way. And that is through Jesus. In 1 Timothy 2:5, it said, for there is one God and one mediator. Do we know what a mediator is? Do you know what a mediator is? Mediator is someone that stands between, like a lawyer or priest that stands between man and God, that represent us for God. Because the verse said, one mediator between God and man, the man Jesus Christ. When he created a body, he became a man with all the limitations that man have, but was sinless. And he's standing our place daily. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's standing our place daily. To represent us before God as the only way, as the only priest, the only high priest to God. Why the enemy, the devil, come before him daily, accusing his people. Do you see that, Lord? Look at that man. That's your servant. Look at that woman. That's your servant. Look what they're doing. That's sin. But God made a way through Jesus. All we have to do is just say, Lord, I repent of my sins. I know I did wrong today. I know my spirit convicted me. The Holy Ghost convicted me of this thing I shouldn't have did or thought or visualized or fantasized or whatever prograded sin or degraded sin I did before thee. I repent. And see, that's the unique thing about Jesus being between us, because our sins are forgiven. When he died on the cross and paid the final sacrifice for our life. The Bible say in the Old Testament how they sacrifice a lamb or a dove or whatever animal they sacrifice during their time in the wilderness. And by Mount Sinai, tell about how they sacrificed an animal to cover all these different sins they did daily. Even the priest had one sacrificed for himself. But when Jesus came, let me tell you about this love, why you should love Jesus, why he sat in heaven, folks. He looked over to the Father and said, Father, make me a body. Make me a human fleshly body to come down on earth to die, to live as a lamb on the earth, like the lamb of the Old Testament. But let me be a lamb that they can offer up to you for all the sins that they can't pay for, Lord. No man is holy enough to stand in this place, because I know man was on his way to be destroyed, completely annihilated off the face of the earth, Lord. But I ask of you, Lord, Holy God, Father, of the Trinity, to give me a body to die for their sin. And you know, people, Jesus came and he died, he sacrificed. He left his throne in heaven as one of the part of the Trinity. And you know what, folks? I was on the internet the other day and I saw this woman. She teach on the Bible and she tell about different races, the colors. But she got to a point where I had to jump in and communicate with her. I had to tell her what my belief. She says she's not a Christian, but she is a follower of Christ. And I said, how can you be a follower of Christ and not a Christian? That didn't make any sense to me. Because she said Christianity means like it's the white man religion. I said a white man religion. For one thing, the word Christian or Christianity, it stands for Christ-like, not white man-like, but Christ-like. And I told her, I believe in what I believe, that to be a Christian, you have to be Christ-like. The Jesus in the Bible, she talked about the races, the black race, how the black race was the original Israelites. And just real deep in and detail. But I said, I don't really care what color they was or where they came from. I'm going by the Bible. It's only one race that I look at. It is the human race. It covers all the races, the black, the green, the purple, whatever color's on this earth, and whatever color Jesus was, doesn't matter. Because he died for your sins. If he didn't exist, if you deny the religion of Christianity, you are denying Jesus. because Jesus was the founder of this religion. He didn't come say, I'm the white man. I declare this religion is only the white man religion, but blacks are not included. No, he came and died for all sins. He didn't predict, the Bible knows, the Bible didn't tell you what race he was. We can research and do what color we thought he was, which I know it probably was a darker race of the Jewish people, you know, compared to the races, but it doesn't matter. Jesus didn't come to emphasize the colors and the races. He came for all. I like in what Luke teaches. I like the part again where Luke tell about Jesus. Luke did, he showed Jesus in the gospel in his short lived ministry. He showed him as a very deeply compassionate man. He didn't emphasize the color. He just talked about the love, the caring for the poor, the oppressed, and how Jesus communicated with all cultural people, nationality, such as the Samaritans, the Gentile, and women's. Wherefore, Matthew traced Jesus' genealogies to Abraham, father of the Jewish people. And Luke goes to Adam, parents of us all. Now, another part I like about Luke, when he zoomed in on women's, who were back then was seen as second-class citizens in the first century, but the birth announcement for Jesus, Luke tells, it was made to shepherds living in the fields, and they were also among the lowest society, in the lowest society pecking order, or very low. Jesus' ministry was for all colors, all nationalities, all people, especially for those that were rejected in their society. And some of Jesus' most powerful parables are uniquely recorded in Luke. You should read them, about the Good Samaritan in chapter 10, 25 to 37 verse, and the rich fool, chapter 12, 13 through 21. And the prodigal son, I'm sure all of you heard about the prodigal son in the chapter 15, 11, 32. And the rich man and Lazarus, definitely read the rich man and Lazarus. That's truly the love of God and Jesus about what happened to a man. Each one of us, they're leaving the earth every day. I think 100-some thousand people die every day. And out of that number, the majority of them is finding their way down in a deadly place, a tragic place called hell. And it wasn't for the love of Jesus. If it wasn't for the love of Jesus, folks, where would we be, Lord? Where would we be? And this is found in also Luke 16. Read the verse 16, chapter 16, 19 through 31. I'm just very grateful for this subject about loving Jesus. Now, I just want to say a prayer again for someone out there who's struggling, who's trying to find out what this love is about Jesus, why he loved me and why should I love him. So Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I ask in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost to touch that person, Lord, right now, who having struggles, Lord, about how to love, what is love, and Jesus' love. Ask you to just touch the mind, Lord, to bring the mind and focus completely on Jesus. Yes, Lord. I thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. And I thank God for the special work he has for me to do. I've been having trouble finding my position. I know Lord called me be a prophet. Also now, along with being a pastor. But I didn't claim the prophet part because I want to be humble. I prefer people to call me Brother Flake or Pastor Flake, or I prefer Brother Flake. But the prophet part, that part that I've been struggling with, because you know, the Lord called you for one office. He some office call you for you. Sometimes you try to ignore it because of your, because you think, oh, it's been, well, I thought, you know, sometimes you try to ignore it because you can't say, not me. And I think I read about Moses, how God called him for a great work. But he made every excuse in the book to not to be this man, to be this prophet, to proclaim the world, to stand up boldly for Christ. I mean, you gotta speak with authority, folks. That's what he put in those certain people that he picked, who will stand up against America, who stand up against the world, who proclaim Jesus to the world. So he gave me this job to be bold and talk with authority, not just the hoop and people don't know what I'm talking about, just to sound like I'm preaching, but to give his anointed message out to the world. To stand on his word. Like now, I try not to speak stuff because God said when his prophets speak, it come to pass. You don't have to have visions and dreams for God to speak through you and proclaim something. It will come to pass. Just like I saw the snow that came last week in the south and headed to the east coast. Just like the Lord said, thus said the Lord. But there's many more things coming, folks. But I'll leave that with you for another program. Well, I thank you for listening to my message today. And guess what? I love Jesus.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting.
Touch my clothes. y'all.
In the name of Jesus.
Go in peace. And behold of thy plague.
Feel, Lord, in the name.